Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the last video of the series How can we improve the TillyWiki documentation using TillyWiki and create pull requests to GitHub. Okay, but before we start with the documentation style guide, if you made it that far in the series, it would be nice if you like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, which is here at youtube.com/PMarioYo, and it would be nice if you hit the subscribe button. And when all the videos are live, it would be nice that you like all of them. Yeah. And if you are already there, you can go to GitHub and open Jeremy's repository, Jermolin TillyWiki 5, and give it a star. Yeah. So I have a new user here, so +1. Yeah. It's always good to have more stars. Yeah, let's go to the documentation guide. I don't want to read all the stuff. You can do this on your own. But I want to point out some information which I think is important. So we have two types of tiddlers. There are instruction tiddlers and reference tiddlers. And with the instruction tiddlers, it says most of it here. Instruction tiddlers talk directly to the reader and guide them through a process. Yeah? So if you know a workflow, how something works, then you should use this workflow and explain it from simple to more complex. Yeah? One takeaway for me is instruction tiddlers talk directly to the reader as you, and they can be reasonably chatty. Yeah, so yeah, there can be some text with it, but also read the last paragraph. Yeah? So this would be important for instruction tiddlers. Reference tiddlers, on the other hand, offer raw information and in a comprehensive interlinked way. Yeah? So for example, all the filter operators have a lot of links, they have the examples and so on, and there is a lot of templating going on. Yeah? So that's important. Reference tiddlers are written in TERS format, formal style. They avoid referring to the reader. Yeah, and they focus on the TillyWiki behavior itself. I think that's important. So references should be, let's say, technical. Yeah? Okay. Yeah. Then there is some information about tiddler title policy, the tiddler structure, some spelling, some typography, and some technical pro style. Yeah? I want to have a closer look at the documentation macros, because I think they are underused a little bit, and yeah, I myself also didn't know too much about them. Preparing the video, I found out that there are some nice elements in it. For example, here we have the icon, an icon size to match the surrounding text. Yeah, I do have with my plugins, I sometimes create documentation, and I use plugins in the normal way. I go to the icon gallery and copy something, and then I use it as a transclusion. This is a globe and some text. Yeah? And if I use it that way, then I have the problem that the globe is way too big. Yeah? And the icon macro solves this problem. Yeah. So that's it. Yeah. Easy. Yeah, and I have to have a look at which classes are there. I have to cover it in a span and define a class and search how the class has to be named. Yeah, on the other hand, it would be easy. Okay, what else is there? Yeah, there are some places. I think strong is not really used, but word is used, and so on. The important thing here is that all of those macros have some styles defined, which makes it easy for us to globally change this stuff. Yeah? So if you write some text, have a look at the existing documentation and also try to use those macros. Yeah? I think most of you know the tip and the warning macro. Also, use those two macros because users know them. Yeah? So, like here, so there is the tip macro and the warning macro. Let's have a look. Warning. Is there? Okay, warning macro looks like this. Don't create your own elements because it may be confusing for new users. Yeah, so they don't know, is it more important than warning or is it less important? Yeah, is it a tip or information? What is more important? Yeah? So only use tip and warning. It's a good thing. Yeah? Then there are some elements. I also didn't know this Tiller Fields thing. Yeah. Tiller Fields Monday will show me the Tiller Fields of every Tiddler. Yeah, so if I create a new Tiddler AA, and if I say Tiddler Fields AA, and here it is. Yeah, easy and nice formatting is already there, can be directly used. What else do we have? Some parameter styles and so on. They look all very similar, but internally they have some HTML elements and they have classes defined. Yeah? Then there are the links. I also would have to experiment with them. I don't know exactly how they work. And the best way is just search them. Yeah? How the TillWiki documentation uses it, and then use it in the same way. Then there are some elements which describe, for example, the sidebar or the tabs. Yeah? So these are the tabs element and these are the parameters. Yeah? So if I want to have sidebar tab, I can say sidebar tab more. Yeah? Yeah, if I have some text, I personally would want to have a little bit more styling around this because I would like to have more that more looks like this. Yeah, so I did create. Did I create some elements? Let's import. Oops, let's import a little bit. Import, yeah. I did play around with some cancel with some elements. So there is the test for the globe again, yeah. Then there is, oops, the icon, the Tiddler Fields. Tab and button, yeah. So there is more and a button. They don't look very nice. So that's why I did play a little bit with the styling. Yeah. So now the more button has a styling, and then I say tab and button. This one. I would like it if it looks like this. Yeah. But yeah, it's important. Without experimenting with the style guide. I wouldn't have seen that this would be maybe better. Yeah. What else is there? If I go to the settings, if I have the settings here, we have the button settings. We have borderless, we have box, we have rounded. So if I say boxed, yeah, then the buttons look like this. My documentation buttons, like this one, yeah, this one should also look like this, yeah. And if I say include text, those buttons look okay. I think this one is also okay. What did I do here? I did cheat a little bit and added the keyboard keyboard HTML element, yeah? So it makes this border around the button. What else is there? We have different palettes. Yeah? So if I change the palette, for example, solarized light, yeah, which looks nice, and I have the more tab here. I would want that this also looks like this here. Yeah? So let's activate the styles again. And this button again, yeah, it's very close, but not really the same. Yeah? And for example, there are different other palettes: contrast light, Cupertino dark, where it doesn't really fit. Yeah, so it's different, very different. So in normal cases, I would like to have this in the same way as the UI. Yeah? Okay, let's go back to the default theme or palette. And switch everything back to default settings. Okay. Okay, why did I mention all this? Because the documentation macros are also kind of old. Yeah? For example, these user interface elements, the key and the key combo, they are not used at all. Yeah? I did have a look at the TillyWiki source code and they aren't used. Yeah? But I know the keyboard widget has some information, but Jeremy wanted to have them like so. Yeah? So they also use the keyboard HTML tag. Yeah? So the ideas behind the style guide are really good. Yeah? But it is 7 years old, yeah. So there should be some updates, yeah, with the possibilities. Also, if we have a closer look at the buttons, they are not aligned as they are aligned here. Yeah. So if I open the drop down here, everything is nicely aligned. Yeah. If I use the button like so, this looks okay, but if I use it in a text, there is the button, yeah, then you can see the alignment doesn't really fit. Yeah. So that's important. I did have a look when the pull request was created. It's pull request number 1417. It's in January, it was created in January 2015, and there is a lot of good ideas, there is a lot of discussion, yeah, so you may read it. It's very interesting, so we can see how the whole thing was intended. And what else can you see? The pull request contained 211 changes in the files, yeah, in the documentation itself. Yeah. So that's quite a bit. Then I had a look at all the macros they are used here, and you can see it's about 640 or 600, yeah, nearly 650 macros, yeah, which I use the documentation macros. Yeah, so if you want to change the whole system, there is a lot of work to do. But if you use it, I think there is a lot to win. Yeah, I also have to play a little bit more with the documentation macros and have a closer look, because I think they will help me also with my plugin documentation. Yeah, yeah, where do they come from? Macros. They are part of the system, and they are part of the TillWiki5 .com documentation only. Yeah, so there has been some discussion in at GitHub that the documentation should be a plugin, but I think we should start with those macros. Yeah, so I'll open them. Yeah. And there we can see it. Yeah, so yeah, they are all wiki text. Yeah, and you should play around with them and experiment a little bit. Yeah, they cannot be seen. Why not? They have no information. So copy this and add them. Operator macros. Close it. Edit. I will create a pull request with the changes that I make here. There are the operator macros, the style guide macros, variable macros. The version macros, they can be already seen, and the wiki text macros, yeah, they are also great. Yeah, so you know them from the copy to clipboard. Yeah, for example, wiki text macro, there is always a copy to clipboard above right button, which is really handy. Yeah. Okay, let's have a look at make pull request. Can we see them? No. They are not there. Oops. Let's have a look. What did we create? We did create. We did change. Those. Okay. Open. Make pull request and add them. 2, 3, 4. Improve readability for documentation macros while I was okay, while I was recording a video, I found out that those macros are not readable by users in view mode. Yeah, yeah, let's try to create the pull request against the TillWiki main repository, and we will see what happens. Yeah, so first make a backup, save everything, and Then we create the pull request. Make PR. Okay. It's loading the library, creating the pull request. Pull request created. Okay. So there are four files have been changed, the different macros, and I did add this pre-element so that we can read it in view mode. Yeah. With the TillyWiki pre-release, it would be possible to define a field which is named code, not body code, or code body, yes, and then it will also be shown, but this doesn't work at the moment. Okay, so let's have a look at the conversation. Let's see what Jeremy says. Okay, what else is there? How can we use the style guides? The documentation macros. Yeah, I told you already that I also will have to experiment a little bit more with those elements. This one should be updated, the user interface. The tabs looks cool, there should be a little bit of CSS. The button should be aligned. Yeah, that's it. At TillyTalk, Mohammed did add a request for help about filter operators. Yeah, and there he did a list of all the filter operators which are new and which may need more documentation. Yeah, there cannot be enough documentation for filter operators. So let's have a look at the sort un operator. Close everything. Sort un. There are two elements. Yeah. And yeah, this looks okay for me. Yeah. This is also nice. Yeah. But you cannot see what's going on. Yeah. I did play a little bit with it, and if I remove the sort un and I only use sort, then I can see that where is the difference between sort and sort. Sort un. Yeah. It interprets the tiller titles as alphanumerics. Yeah. So there should be a little bit of information here how user should write so that it makes a difference and they can see what's going on. Then it uses the Apple tiddler, and if you open it, it's empty. Yeah. So if a new user comes to this Apple tiddler and opens it, then they see, okay, it's a demonstrations, but nothing else. Okay. There is a similar tiddler which also uses a list element. Yeah. If I open Apple, I see the list is used to create the list. Yeah. But there is no text. The Days of the Week tiddler is very similar, but has this nice information. Yeah? So let's have a look at it, and we see this is heavily scripted, so we just copy the content and add this information to the Apple tiddler, and now it says, okay, this Apple tiddler, this example tiddler is used to illustrate some of the filter operators. It has a list field containing the following items, and there are the items. Okay, yeah, this makes a difference. And now we open the examples and say, okay, try the following example with sort instead of sort an. Okay, let's have a look. Say hide. Yeah. So now if the user opens it, it says, okay, these examples make use of the Apple Tiddler. If they click the Apple Tiddler, they get some information. And now they say, see, okay, try the following example with sort instead of sort on. Okay, try it and change it to sort. Okay, it makes a difference. Yeah. I don't think it's perfect. Yeah, there is room for improvement, but it makes a difference, and I think it improves the documentation a little bit. Yeah? So let's have a look. Make a pull request. There is the Apple, the sort on. I don't need them anymore. I didn't change this one. Yeah, that's okay. So let's say improve the docs for the sort on operator. So the Apple Tiddler didn't have any body text, and let's say the example has some more info for a new user what to test. Okay, I don't know. Let's have a look. That's it. Make a backup and save it as JSON. Okay, and create the pull request. Make a pull request. Pull request created. Two files changed. Okay, the Apple has a field now. Okay. So we can say make a screenshot. How can I make a screenshot? Where is it? There should be a screenshot button. Bookmark history, downloads, more toolbar. Nah. Customize toolbar. Somewhere there is a screenshot. Ah, here, screenshot. Yeah, take this one. Say done. Okay, we make a screenshot, use this element and copy it and say the Apple Tiddler looks like this now. Okay. Yeah, and the example screenshot, save visible, there I can say so, like so, copy, the example looks like this. Okay, yeah, So now Jeremy has a better information what the pull request tries to change, and we will see if it goes through or not. We will see. So if there is some discussion, we may need to change it, but that's not a problem. That's part of the game. Yeah. Okay. So that's it with the style guide. Yeah. So there was a little bit of ranting, but what I wanted is that you try the style guide your own, that you play with it. Yeah. Especially the documentation macros. I think they are not utilized very well, and we should package them into a plugin so plugin authors can also use them for their editions, where we have to create documentation. And the more the macros are used, the more feedback we get, and the better they will get in the end. So, yeah, that's the point that I wanted to make. Yeah, open the documentation style guides, read this information, and create pull requests. I think it's simple. You saw during this video, I made two pull requests. Yeah, I'm not sure if they are okay. Yeah, but I made them and I made a point, and it can be discussed. Yeah, so it's better as it was before. Yeah, that's it for the series. It would be nice, if you go to my YouTube channel and like and subscribe all the videos. Go to Jeremy and Star the repository. And yeah, if you like it, then comment. You can comment here, or you can then comment at Tiddly Talk. Yeah, I will create a new thread which introduces all the videos. And see you soon. Thank you.